I'm at Dover Air Force Base, Delaware, investigating what it takes to keep the US Air Force's fleet of giant super galaxy cargo planes airworthy.
I can feel it in my chest, the power it takes to get that into the air.
But back in the 1960s, the Super Galaxy's original designers needed new supersized engines to get it airborne.
But even on something that big, there's a limit to the size of engine it can carry. They needed to find a way of making those engines bigger without making them bigger.
Hidden away here amongst thousands of acres of hills and forests in Peebles, Ohio, is the testing facility of General Electric, the company that developed and built the Super Galaxy's engines.
Oh, wow. This is a specialized workshop. You can feel it. The air is crackling with precision in here.
I'm here to meet Steve Scavo, one of the engineers responsible for designing and maintaining the big plane's jets.
Is this actually off a Super Galaxy?
It is. This engine's actually been on wing for over 12 years.
So how long is this going to be in for what I suspect is quite an expensive service?
We target 90 days.
Yeah.
I suspect it'll take longer. But that's our target.
Depends what you find in there.
Yes.
Okay, well, look, this is a jet engine. It is, to the layman, just a mass of pipes and tubes. It looks like the back of the most complicated washing machine ever.
A regular jet engine mixes air and fuel in a combustion chamber and then propels the resulting exhaust out the back. That's what delivers thrust. But General Electric came up with a radical modification. They added a huge turbofan at the front, which drives more air at high speed into the combustion chamber, and crucially, even more air through a bypass chamber around the outside of it. Forcing air around as well as through the combustion chamber made these high bypass engines more powerful than ever before, and revolutionized air travel.
This is hauling in huge amounts of air.
Correct, about 42 tons of air per minute.
42 tons of air goes pulled in through there.
Yes.
And I can see around the outside, that's where it doesn't all go into the engine. So this is the bypass bit.
Correct. So for this particular engine, the ratio of air that bypasses the core and exits through the fan is 8 to 1.
So 8 parts out here to 1 in there.
Yes.
So the majority of the air is going around the engine and then exiting at the back.
Correct.
With more mass to push you forward.
Correct.
And this was a massively significant development in aviation engines.
It's virtually the configuration that's on every commercial aircraft today.
So I think there's a figure that at any given moment, there's something like 1.25 million people in the air on commercial flights, and nearly
right.
all of them being powered by engines at this time.
That's correct.
So it moves the world.
Yes.
Before any jet engine goes into service, it has to be rigorously tested. But they're so powerful, that can only happen in enormous buildings constructed to withstand the colossal forces involved.
This is one of the most specialized rooms I've ever been in. It is only for testing jet engines. I'm trying hard to avoid saying awesome, but I can't. It's awesome. Look at that! Probably this isn't the best place to be when it starts.
So I'm making my excuses and heading to meet Michael Giordano in the control room.
So what do you actually do to try and test these engines to the limit?
We closely monitor, you know, the fan speed, core speed, EGT, fuel pressure, and our thrust.
How do they test?
They test to 57,000 pounds of thrust.
57,000 pounds?
Correct.
The high bypass innovation was revolutionary. It delivered all the thrust the plane needed without adding any weight.
There is no replacement planned for the C5 Super Galaxy, and it's been future-proofed to 2045, by which time, well, it'll be getting on for 100 years old. Best part of a century of service carrying out critical missions in war and peacetime. across the globe. That is an appropriately big career for a very big plane that does a very, very big job.